Hi all. There is a saying that asking the right question is as important as answering them. Today, being the third day of Swasthya 365, we, the Rotary Club of Savita Medical College, is here to answer some of the frequently asked questions. Is COVID caused by a bacteria? No, COVID-19 belongs to a virus family called Coronaviridae. Antibiotics do not work on viruses. Do prolonged wearing of face masks cause CO2 intoxication? No, wearing medical masks properly ensuring sufficient airflow neither cause CO2 intoxication nor O2 deficiency. Do hydroxychloroquine and certain drugs cure and prevent COVID-19? No, there are currently no drugs licensed to prevent or treat COVID-19. Is exposing oneself to temperature more than 25 degrees prevent or cure COVID-19? No, exposing yourself to temperature more than 25 degrees would not prevent or cure COVID-19 since countries with hot climate has reported cases of COVID-19. Can cold weather and snow kill new novel coronavirus? No, same as how hot climate doesn't kill coronavirus, cold climate can't too. Does vaccine against pneumonia and hemophilus influenza type B provide protection against coronavirus? No, the virus is so new that it needs its own vaccines. Does rinsing the mouth regularly with saline help you prevent coronavirus? No, there is no proven evidence. Does eating garlic can prevent coronavirus? No, there is no proven evidence. Do certain antibiotics work effectively against coronavirus? No, antibiotics do not work on viruses, but antibiotics are given to help against additional bacterial infections which patient may suffer from. Is there any drugs available for COVID-19? There is no definitive medicine for the treatment. However, researchers and ongoing trials are bringing in a few medicine like favipiravir, zinc and vitamin C to treat. And now we are moving to the most important part, that is the nutrition for the adult. As we are still yet to find a proper solution to this dangerous viral disease, the only way to fight it is to become stronger and healthier. An ideal diet should contain a maximum of 200 to 300 ml of warm water to start the day, followed by 250 ml of immune booster juice an hour later. The composition of the immune booster should be gooseberry, ginger, turmeric and tulasi. Again, after an hour and a half, a healthy breakfast consisting of millet pongal or idli with ginger or tomato chutney is a good option. For the protein content, a cup of sprouts in any form along with green salads and fruits would make an ideal breakfast. For the mid-morning break, carrot juice or pineapple juice or buttermilk should be apt. Lunch becomes the king of all the meals as it should have boiled rice or millet, sambar, kirai kootu, boiled sweet potato, rasam and buttermilk. Well, tea break is relatively simple with a cup of sprouts along with an immune booster hot drink. This time the immune booster consists of tulasi, ginger, pepper, adimadhuram and turmeric all boiled together and strained to form a flavored hot drink. Well, the last meal for the day should be taken relatively only by 7 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. and it should be a little one too. It is ideal if it is a millet or rice khichdi or pongal with sambar or chutney. If this diet is followed, it is for sure people will head towards a fitter world without fear. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.